what do you think you want to do when you graduate from high school someday?
I'm trying to get into my singing career or my acting career.
So you sing too?
Yeah, I want to do that. When I get older, I want to be both.
Were you born here in Austin?
No, I was born in Grand Prairie, Texas, in Dallas.
When I was about 7 years old, I told my mom that I wanted to be an actress and that I wanted to be on TV and I wanted to perform. I pretty much entertained myself growing up. I was an only child, so I would always sing. I'd always play around with music and I always performed and entertained my friends and people that weren't even there. Definitely liked entertaining. I was very dramatic as a kid. So my mom, of course, supported me and I went on my first audition ever, which was Barney. I didn't know what a prop was, I didn't know what a producer was, I didn't know what anything was in that world. About 12 years old, Disney Channel had a nationwide casting search, and I auditioned, and I guest starred on their shows, other shows, and then I landed Wizards.
The show is called Wizards of Waverly Place, and it's about a family of kids who are being taught wizardry by our father. At the same time, we're trying to go to school and be normal and everything, and none of the kids at school know we can do magic.
I love acting and I love music. I find that in different periods of my life, I'm obsessed with one more than the other, but I can't trust it because it always goes back and forth for me. Acting was the first one that kind of took off for me, which was wonderful, and I love it, and I was able to do wonderful things, and I'm continuing to live that dream. The thing that sparked me wanting to do music more was probably the singer that I was named after, because I was named after Selena, and obviously, it's my name. When I found out that I was going to Europe for my music, I was so excited. It's something that I've always wanted to do. I think any musician's dream is to be able to tour their music all over the world. I didn't really know what to expect with my music, going overseas, meeting people, knowing that there would be a language barrier. So I was very nervous, but a good kind of nervous because it was a new thing that I was taking on.
I hope that I get to meet my fans all around the world. And I hope that I'm able to inspire people with my music and to go and have a good time and learn.
What I expected from the trip was really just going out there, starting over, basically. Educating people on my show and who I was and hopefully just starting a whole new thing overseas, which I was completely prepared to do. I knew that I had a couple of fans that would Twitter me from overseas, so I was very excited to meet them. I didn't think that there would be more than like maybe 100 or so that I would meet and hopefully make some new fans and meet new people. When I saw Europe for the first time, the culture was absolutely the first thing that I gravitated towards. It was amazing. The buildings, the streets, the cobblestones, the people, the little cafes, everything. I just completely felt like I was in a different place. I definitely didn't feel like I was in California. Every city, every country I went to, I was just blown away. The fans were amazing. I didn't expect the reaction I got. Being in Europe and going to different places, my mom and I and Brian would be in the car and we're like, man, I hope people show up, you know? We're like, I hope people are there. And stepping on stage in Spain was insane. I just had this overwhelming feeling, and they were different kind of feelings that I'd never had before. I couldn't really understand them with the language barrier half the time, and I felt so bad because I tried my best to learn some of the language everywhere I went to say thank you and to let them know how much I appreciate their love and their support.
I'm learning that one in Spanish.
Está aprendiendo esa en español.
I need your help.
Okay, so it goes,
eres el trino y yo soy el rayo. And then, tan intenso y apasionado. No todo fue tan natural cuando estamos juntos. Porque todo es natural, tan natural. Baby, baby.
Thank you.
I always try to make myself available for my fans. Wherever I go, I always ask Brian and my mom to make sure that they book time before or after an event or something that I'm doing so that I'm able to meet my fans.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for coming.
I did a signing once and they had me on the schedule to do it for 2 hours. And I didn't have anywhere else to go after that. I couldn't leave and I stayed there for 7 hours. Because I couldn't. And it doesn't seem like work for me, it really doesn't. I love meeting my fans. I love talking to them. It's really great. It's a good bonding experience. I mean, you're not gonna be closer to your fans than meeting them, so. I guess the whole idea of having people look up to you is a very big deal. And it still, to this day, kind of surprises me whenever I hear, I wanna be like you when I grow up, or, you know, I admire you and I look up to you, because that's a lot, if you think about that sentence, especially from like little kids, because I'm just a girl who's very lucky and living her dream and being able to do these wonderful things. But like when a kid says that, it's a huge deal for me. And I try my best to honor that. So going to a different country and seeing people outside the hotel, and there were a couple of people that slept outside, and it was just, it was crazy for me to see that.
Selena Gomez es la mejor.
Porque es la mejor en todos los sentidos.
Y hemos venido de Alicante aquí a ver.
¿Cuánto tiempo habéis tardado en llegar aquí de Alicante?
Pues porque vinimos en avión, pero como íbamos con retraso, es una hora, hora y media.
Yo he tardado 3 horas, señor. Yo soy de Zamora, he tardado 3 horas para no ver.
Y estamos aquí gritando a ver si abre la ventana y...
No sé, le decimos algo y que...
Por su...
¡Selena!
¡Selena, baja!
My fans mean the entire world to me. I'm just a kid myself, so it's really wonderful to be able to relate to kids my age or younger or even older. They're so energetic and wonderful and really just empowering and encouraging. I always try to tell my fans that I never really can truly explain to them how grateful I am for them. I can't really understand the fact that I can just go on a stage for an hour and sign as many autographs as I can, and they're okay with that. And they wait 10 hours, fly from different countries, and wait all day. And me just doing that is good enough. I don't feel like that's enough. They're amazing.
Selena gets up at 7 o'clock in the morning every day, and we have to go be somewhere for sound check at a certain time. She'll have 5 interviews by the time we sound check. She'll come to sound check, have 5 interviews after sound check. We'll do our show, and she'll take a 5-minute nap and then go do some other interview. She'll do press, interviews, talk about her movie, talk about her show, talk about her music, talk about her fashion line.
She handles it so well, too. It's like literally every minute of her day is planned down to the minute.
A lot of people don't really know what their place in the world is, but she's so into what she does, and she knows who she is, and works very hard at it and appreciates everything that she has going for her. So that's really cool.
Traveling, period, can make you exhausted. I definitely feel like there are days where I just want to completely unplug and not talk to anyone. My parents, my family, they all give me that energy of love and support, and I feel like that's the key ingredient in all of it.
I'm actually currently working on my second record, so hopefully I'll be able to go out and tour two records.
Whoa, already? Two records already?
Yeah, I'm enjoying music.
I never knew what was going on half the time. I just showed up. I was like, is this fans or business? That was what I always said. I'm like, is this fans or business? Is this one fans or business? And you can tell which one I like better, to be honest. But I think because I'm never in Europe and it was my first time, I wanted to give my all. So I didn't really mind doing the long days.
Au revoir.
No.
Au revoir.
A-U-V-O-I-R.
Au revoir.
I mean, when you're in a foreign situation and you don't know what's going on and you don't know if you're saying the right line whenever you're doing a promo, there's just, the only thing you can do is laugh. And that's all I did. Half the time I was just laughing at myself because I was trying really hard and I didn't want to offend anyone. And, you know, I was in their home, so I wanted to be the best guest I could, but it was so hard to keep a straight face half the time because I couldn't understand anything. I was in Germany and I had to do a bunch of interviews on this couch and this lovely lady came in and she spoke English and it was kind of broken, so I tried to piece it together as much as possible. And we were talking about friends and what I did in my downtime. And I told her I liked hanging out and I liked getting yogurt with my friends. And she thought I said yoga.
I would get yogurt at my favorite yogurt place.
What's
the name of the studio? Menchie's. Uh-huh, that's great. There's so many people in yoga that
do
two times
a week. It's great.
Do
you make other sports?
No.
Just yoga?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
yogurt.
She thinks she said yoga.
Oh, I thought she said, do I do yoga?
No, I thought you're in yoga. We fun yoga or the sports, I mean.
Do I do yoga?
Yeah.
No.
That was good. I bet you she did not put me in her magazine at all that month. But that's okay, that's understandable. I tried my best to visit every place as best as I could. I know it was very brief, but I tried to fit in as much as possible every place. I mean, you can fit the Louvre in 20 minutes, right? Our family, when we're traveling and we're bored and we're the only people we've got, is simplicity. The littlest things can make us happy, like cake or, you know, food, whatever it may be. But we were in a car and we had these wonderful European phones that I felt like I was going to break every time I tapped on, and they played these amazing ringtones. She's a good person that just likes to laugh at herself. She'll always try to impersonate me. It's pretty funny. So them singing my song, I can have no comment on, and I'm sorry. Those are my parents. I live with them.
Go back, come on.
Family means the world to me. I love my family. I grew up with a big family in Texas. So my mom and my stepdad go everywhere with me. Although I do work with a lot of adults and I kind of essentially an adult job. At the end of the day, I'm still a kid and I like having my mom with me. And my mom's like my best friend, so I'm able to tell her everything and she goes through everything with me. So it's really nice to have that love and support, because in the end of the day, no one's gonna love you more or fight for you more than your own family. Whenever I started this whole adventure with my music and everything, she was all I had on the road. And so I was really able to spend time with her, and I appreciate all the sacrifices that she's made for me. And as a family, they've all made lots of sacrifices just so that I could live my dream. So we've been through a lot as a family. And I think that this trip has definitely made us closer, if it was possible. I'm only 17, so I have to have parents with me because I'm growing up and I'm figuring out who I am. And it's good to have the authority, because in a scary way, I have the authority. Not with my family, but whenever I'm working or I'm on stage and I'm, you know, thinking creatively of how I want this to go and how I want this to go. And although it is a collaboration, I have that power in a way that no 17-year-old really should have. And so it's good to have my parents with me because they're my authority. They know I'm not bigger or less than anyone. And I like that. And once I'm off the clock, it's back to my room. So I think it's very important to have them on the road, especially at this time in my life, because eventually they won't be able to go everywhere with me. And I'm gonna need to make sure I'm a good person. And I have them to thank for that. For me, I always used to say, like, I love this and I want this job to be my life, but I do not want it to live my life for me. You know, I wanna be able to make my mistakes and still be a kid and still have my mom to tell me no. Still have my mom to ground me and take my phone away from me or something. It's good to have that. Recording my first record was, it feels like a lifetime ago. I didn't really know where I was musically. I didn't know what I wanted to do. I kind of just used all the artists that I loved at that time, and I kind of mirrored their sound. I was really into like Kelly Clarkson and Pink and very girl empowered music. So I think the first record kind of mirrored that whole teen angst and me wanting to be kind of pop rock. I think music has definitely opened me up a lot more when it comes to myself and my connection with my fans. Acting, you're given direction and you're given a script. Towards music, I'm in the studio and I'm able to work on music that I can personally relate to, and hopefully my fans can relate to it as well. But the moment that I tour it and I step out on stage and I'm able to see my fans and kind of pretty much just be myself on stage, no script, nothing, it is very terrifying, but it has allowed me to open up in ways that I never knew I really could. How you choose to express yourself, it's all your own and I can tell. It comes naturally. The funny thing about Naturally, it was the last song that I put on the album. I didn't even want it on the album because it didn't really fit with everything else. And I remember the producers were like, you know, just listen to the song and feel it for a little bit. And when I was singing it, it just gave me this awesome feeling. I just wanted to dance and it made me happy. And I had such a great time recording it. And that song was a blessing in disguise because it took me to a whole different place. I kind of think that music is all about sharing it with everyone and just hanging out and listening and having a good time. And that song represents that. It's a feel-good kind of song. Musically, it put me on top 40 and I gained fans that didn't have any idea who I was. And then when I came overseas to promote the single, they already knew the song, which was crazy. Everywhere I went, they were singing that song to me. It's on your own and I can't tell, it comes naturally. Oh yeah! It comes naturally. Have having to use a translator to talk to your fans is difficult, period. But the moment that you mention a title of a song, they sing it to you in English. And then you kind of forget about the barrier and you kind of have this instant, immediate connection with them. Seeing my name on the top 10 chart right under Beyonce and Lady Gaga, never in a million years would I think that it would get the reaction it got.
We got your first official chart position for the single, and naturally, I'm very pleased to tell you, has gone straight in at number 5 in the single charts, making you one of our top debut single artists on Hollywood Records.
Oh my gosh, look.
Oh, they're awesome. Like,
it's really different from surfing.
I think it looks very intense. Different from surfing. Yeah.
It's almost like a little family type vibe.
That's right.
We're like a 4-man, 1-woman wolf pack.
When I started music, I wanted to be in a band. I really didn't want to be a solo artist because I come from an ensemble cast on my show where I have family around me that supports me. And I kind of wanted to make that family element into music. So I wanted a band. Now, the scene is actually a funny story because we came up with the band name, I think it was actually my mom. When I stepped into the music world, a lot of people were very critical because, of course, you're trying something new and people don't know exactly how well it's gonna go. One of the things that I got over and over again was I'm a wannabe scene. And that's kind of like a style. I guess, you know, like the rocker chick kind of thing. So I was like, all right, well, if you can't beat them, join them. So I named my band that. Selena Gomez in the Scene.
2, 3. Light and Rain!
We did a huge audition process. Not only were we trying to find awesome musicians, we wanted to have people that had awesome personalities, people that I could click with and people that kind of had the same morals as I did when it came to my music and the idea of it, and wanted to make sure that they had a sense of humor. And I found 4. I have Ethan, who's on lead guitars. I have Joey on bass, Greg on drums, and Dane on keys. These people are your family. They are your forced family. They have to travel with you, and you know, they catch you on your worst days, on your best days, and I love that. I feel very, very comfortable with them. And I feel like I really can be myself with them. They're all so much fun, and we all just collaborate really well, and I feel very lucky to have them a part of my band. Because it is my first show overseas, so I'm kind of honored to be able to perform in front of them tonight. It should be fun.
We've been waiting for 3 hours. She's an inspiration. She's our idol.
She's amazing. We want
Selena. That show sold out in 10 minutes, and I couldn't believe it. Knowing that I was in a different comfort zone and a different part of the world performing my music, that was also going through my mind before I was going on stage. I love being in the studio and I love the creative process and, you know, picking out cool wardrobe and things like that, all the things that piece it together, but what pays off is being on stage. That's what's the best part. I love being able just to walk out and see all of my fans and actually get to connect with them with the songs, through the songs, and get different reactions from different places. Before every show, I have this thing, we call it lockdown, where nobody comes into the dressing room and it's just me and my band. And that's just really a moment for us to get out of our regular day-to-day life mode and get into our rock zone.
Yeah.
There are so many emotions that go through my head right before I go on stage, no matter how many times I do it, no matter like who I'm going at. I mean, it's my fans. If anything, they're comforting as well, but I still get so nervous. And that feeling, it's just like, I'm scared, I'm nervous, I'm remembering the first lyric of the first song, I'm hearing the crowd, and I'm just taking it all in just 30 seconds, and then I go on stage. And the rest is just, I don't even remember it. It's just an adrenaline rush. I'm really nervous. That loud, and I didn't expect them to know pretty much every lyric to the songs. I remember I was literally on stage at one point, and I looked at Joey, and I'm going, oh my gosh, can you do you hear this? Like, this is insane. They knew every single lyric, and it's amazing because you work so hard to put this album together, or any album together, and then once you hear them enjoying it just as much as you, that's the craziest feeling in the world. My favorite musicians that perform live, it's all about presence, and it's all about just literally feeling the words that you're singing and just having so much fun. I remember when I started performing my album, nobody knew any of my songs. So I was just going on stage, trying to at least hope they would pay attention or get their attention in some way. So it's great to see the album come out a little bit more. Recording is going very well. We have recorded so far the entire record here, and everyone's really nice. I was very surprised. This is probably one of the nicest studios I've ever recorded in, and it's in Budapest. Second record is so different than my first one. I kind of have a better idea of what I want to accomplish on stage and what I want to have with my music and for my fans, and I've definitely grown a lot musically, and I think that the second record really shows that. If there's one thing that I've learned from my whole musical experience, is definitely just to be more daring and to just put yourself out there more in a good way. I mean, like I said before, it's just really opened me up to just kind of embrace different sides of myself that I didn't really know was there. Bring them back now, you got me singing. It's an instant connection with a song. Whenever I listen to it and I immediately fall in love with it, whether it's the lyric that I like or the beat, something that's got the melody, something that I love about it, I have to have it. So for me, that's kind of my connection with the song. So far, piecing together all the music that I've put out, I have and instant reactions to it. Everything has changed, your love is off the chain. Everything has changed, everything has changed. No, everything has changed, your love is off the chain. A thousand church bells ringing, I can hear the angels singing. When you call my name, your love is off the chain. My voice has definitely changed a lot. We're trying new things with the music and my voice as well. We're kind of doing different styles. I'm more confident in the lyrics that I'm singing. I'm more confident in my voice and just kind of wanting to put this together to display for my fans, saying this is what has pulled me out of the whole little world and this is what I got, you know, out of my first little record to this. So hopefully everyone enjoys it because I'm having a blast recording it. I just think that music makes everything better. Whenever you're having a good day, you can listen to music to make it even better. Whenever I'm having a sad day, I listen to sad music. I don't know why, I just do. And I think that there's such a powerful connection with music in general. If there's a song that you can relate to, or if there's something that you're going through and you can gravitate towards the lyrics in the song, that's just what music is about for me. So as a 17-year-old girl, I go through the typical things, friendship, love, and all the things that you're kind of exploring and trying to figure out who you are. That's what I try to translate in my music. And I feel like every kid goes through those things. So whenever I have a concert or whenever I'm putting an album together, I keep that in mind. I always think, okay, can my fans relate to this? Can people relate to this? And that's just a whole other way for me to connect with them, which is all I really love doing. We'll be right back.